Hello, you're watching Proactive Investors. I'm Karen Tan. Heading over to Perth now to talk to Ian Prentice. He's the Managing Director of Technology Metals Australia. Hi, Ian, how are you?
Hi, Karen. Very well, thank you.
Now, the big news for your company this week, today, is that you've secured a new memorandum of understanding with a China-based rare metal manufacturer. Congratulations. Can you tell us about that? What are the details?
Yeah, thank you, Karen. As I've been talking about for a little while now, we've been talking to end users and potential offtake partners for a while about engaging around our vanadium product. And we're very pleased to have announced yesterday the memorandum of understanding with the China Nonferrous subsidiary, a specialty metals materials subsidiary that is looking to engage in acquiring some of our products, some of our vanadium pentoxide, so they can produce some vanadium alloys for the steel industry. So it's a really important step for us, engaging with a very significant counterparty like that. And also in the MoU, there's quite a lot of detail around what the binding agreement that we're working towards will look like, and that's really key for us. So we're very, very pleased with having this initial step, and looking forward to the next little while of negotiating through to the final agreement.
Any specific terms of the MoU?
So the MoU had some minimum volumes in it, and it also talked about take or pay, and we also talked about some sort of pricing structures that we'll be then negotiating around to get the pricing into the final agreement. There's also an introduction in there through to their parent company, China Nonferrous, and that'll be something that we'll be looking at over the next little while to talk to them about, engaging them in the project at a different scale, whether it's on a financing or being involved in the construction of the project. So those sort of discussions. So it's a really good entree into that part of the market. So, and I think importantly, this is just our first step. We're looking to engage with a number of groups around on the volume side. We're aiming to be producing around about 12 to 13,000 tonnes per annum of V2O5. This initial MOU is for 2,000 tonnes as a minimum. So we'll be looking to engage with other groups. And as I said, we've been talking to other groups for quite some time now. So as we progress the definitive feasibility study over the next few months, we're aiming, and we've informed the market that'll be coming out mid this year. So it's getting very close. We will be aiming to progress a whole bunch more of those discussions around MOUs and then progressing those to binding agreements.
What project will it benefit in particular?
Yeah, so the product will be coming from our Gabanintha vanadium project. That's the intent. And as I say, we're progressing through the definitive feasibility study on that at the moment. So the intent is to engage with these groups to take a large proportion of our planned production from Gabanintha over the mine life.
How's that project going? What stage is it at?
Yeah, so it's going very, very well. We've been completing some pilot plant test work, and we've been talking to the market for some little time about this. We generated a bulk sample last year, and that's been progressing through the different stages of pilot plant test work. So in the month of May, we've been doing the kiln test work. So that's a really key part of proving scalability of our process, and hopefully in the next little while we'll be able to inform the market of the results of that kiln test work and demonstrating that the test work that we've been doing at lab scale, we've been able to scale up to a larger scale for pilot plant test work, and that's a really key, the final building block that will go into our definitive feasibility study.
Good work. And any other news flow we can look forward to?
So really, it's very much focused on the feasibility study. As I say, we're talking to other groups around MOUs around offtake. We never know how those discussions will progress, but that's a real clear focus for us. And really, as I say, progressing the DFS through to completion.
Ian Prentice, lovely to talk to you, and thanks so much for your time.
Thank you very much.
Thanks. That's Ian Prentice from Technology Metals Australia.